The ancestor of the supreme leader Karagiorgi, great-great-grandson of Crown Prince Alexander, great-grandson of King Peter I, grandson of King Alexander I, son of King Peter II. He is His Royal Highness Crown Prince Alexander. Last December was marked by a beautiful family event, the christening of young Prince Stefan, the son of their Royal Highnesses Prince Philip and Princess Danica, at the Royal Chapel of St. Andrews, the first called. Stefan was christened by His Holiness Patriarch Irinay of Serbia, and his godparents were Prince Alexander, twin brother of Prince Philip, Miss Petra Lazarevich and Mr. Dusan Antunovic, long-standing family friends. Joining the Patriarch in officiating the christening was His Grace Bishop Lavrenti of Shabats, who married their Royal Highnesses Crown Prince Alexander and Crown Princess Catherine in 1985, and he also christened Prince Philip and Alexander. Prince Stefan wore the christening gown that His Majesty King Peter II wore on the day of his christening, officiated by His Holiness Patriarch Dimitri of Serbia in 1923 in Belgrade, and his godfather was King George V. Their Royal Highnesses welcomed the birth of their new great-grandson. Jack is the first grandchild for their daughter Alison and the first child of her son Nicholas and daughter-in-law Nicolette. As every year, the Crown Prince Alexander Foundation for Culture and Education is very active, and it hosted for its 18th consecutive year the traditional reception for more than 600 valedictorian high school students from Serbia and the Republic of Srpska at the White Palace in Dedinje. This event was sponsored by NCR Corporation and thanks to collaboration with Ling Group. The best graduated students were granted scholarships for their prestigious ITA Academy. Traditionally, Crown Prince's Foundation also provided a scholarship for the prestigious Culver Military Academy camp.
Sam vrlo ponosna moja škola gdje sam bio pre mnogo godina. Mi smo dobili stipendije I svake godine šaljemo neko tamo.
Jako sam srećna I zadovoljna zbog svega što mi se dešava. Zahvalna sam fundaciji prestolonaslednika Aleksandra zbog pružene prilike. Od letnjeg kampa Kalvara očekujem da ću upoznati puno svojih vršnjaka, da ću naučiti nove stvari I usavršiti engleski jezik.
Another important family event was the celebration of the Patron Saint's Day of the Family, St. Andrew I called, when His Holiness Irinay, the Serbian Patriarch, officiated the Holy Liturgy in the Royal Chapel. On the occasion of Slava, Archimandrite Metodije, prior of the Hilandar Monastery, donated to the royal family three authentic crosses, one made of Hilandar olive tree, the second of the Ohrid Lake shell, and the third of silver. All three crosses were consecrated on the piece of the Holy Cross of which Jesus Christ was crucified, which Saint Sava brought to Hilandar from Nicaea 8 centuries ago. One of the crosses was given to His Royal Highness Prince Stefan at his christening, and the other two are intended for the future members of the royal family. In April 2019, the royal compound officially was opened for the Jubilee 15th tourist season. Before royal families coming back to Serbia, the royal compound was closed to the public, and opening it for the tourists was one of the first important decisions of its head, His Royal Highness Crown Prince Alexander. Having traditionally tight relations with the crown, Serbian Patriarch Irinay always stressed the strong connection between the royal family and the church, and Crown Prince Alexander respects this relation and the orthodoxy, like the all other religions as well. The traditional dinner in honor of bishops of the Serbian Orthodox Church participating in the regular church assembly was hosted by His Royal Highness Crown Prince Alexander at the White Palace, and Christmas Eve was marked by the traditional burning of the Yule log in front of the Royal Palace. Their Royal Highnesses also attended the Christmas Holy Liturgy in the crypt of St. Sava Temple, as well as the Holy Liturgy and procession on the Nativity of Mary, the patron saint day of Topola. On the occasion of Vidovdan, their Royal Highnesses Crown Prince Alexander and Crown Princess Catherine attended the Holy Liturgy officiated by His Holiness the Serbian Patriarch Irinay at St. Lazar Church in Belgrade. Traditionally, numerous artistic exhibitions and gatherings are organized at the White Palace with the support of the royal family. Royal furniture, exhibition Peter I, King Liberator in the Works of Art, amongst the Museum Night, International Cuisine Dinner, Telegroup InfoSec Conference, Donor Dinner in aid of Faculty of Political Sciences. Crown Prince Alexander was an honorary guest at the presentation of the book Alexander II Karadjordjevich, Contributions for Biography by Professor Nikola Moravcevich, member of the Crown Council. Crown Prince Alexander travels extensively, meeting with a large number of world leaders, politicians, members of the royal families and influential figures. The royal couple attended the 67th annual National Prayer Breakfast in Washington. Also, their Royal Highnesses met with President Donald Trump and Mrs. Melania Trump at Mar-a-Lago Club in Palm Beach in Florida, as every year. Their Royal Highnesses, Crown Prince Alexander and Crown Princess Catherine, also attended the 70th birthday celebration of His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales at Buckingham Palace. At the Palais Royal in Monaco, their Royal Highnesses, Crown Prince Alexander and Crown Princess Catherine met with His Serene Highness Prince Albert II. To support our people abroad, the royal couple attended a celebration marking half a century since the consecration of the Church of the Holy Prince Lazar in Birmingham. His Royal Highness Crown Prince Alexander laid the cornerstone in 1968, and they also attended Saint Sava celebration at Saints Peter and Paul Antiochian Orthodox Church Hall in the Potomac, Maryland, which serves the metropolitan area of Washington, D.C. The royal couple paid respect to medical missions and individuals in the Balkan Wars 1912-1913 and the First World War 1914-1918 who assisted the Serbian Army Medical Corps by laying wreaths on the memorial plates in the Serbian Medical Association building. And Crown Prince Alexander, accompanied by Honorary Branko Terzic, member of the Privy Council, laid a wreath at Galovica Field near Pranjani, where Operation Halyard took place, the biggest Allied airlift operation behind enemy lines during the World War II. Crown Prince Alexander attended also the Armistice Day state ceremony at the Serbian Military Cemetery, the Commonwealth War Cemetery, the Russian Military Cemetery, and the French Military Cemetery, where he laid wreaths together with other dignitaries. The royal couple attended the opening of the exhibition Together We Win about American-Serbian friendship, organized on the occasion of the 100th anniversary of Serbian Day in the United States of America, the 28th of July 1918, as well as the opening of the exhibition of paintings entitled Art Awaiting Justice, 5th of October 2000, at the National Assembly of the Republic of Serbia, and they were the honorary patrons of the Second Serbian International Sports Medicine Conference. His Royal Highness Crown Prince Alexander kicked off at a charity football match between Serbia's journalists and the Kingdom of Serbia Association teams, which was played in honor of the 100th anniversary of the Kingdom of Serbia's victory in the Great War. The match was played at the King Peter I Football Club Rad Stadium, and all the proceeds from the tickets sold were allocated for the shelter for homeless children in Belgrade. Alexander II, the Conciliator. He reconciles the values of family, humanity, people, and faith. He brought democracy to the country. He is a crown prince from the people, working and caring for his people. He honorably carries the name of his ancestors and nourishes the Karadjordjevich tradition. Unity, stability, continuity, features of a constitutional parliamentary monarchy, they are fully represented by His Royal Highness Crown Prince Alexander.